Hello students, up to now we covered introduction, history, origin, the general account, the classification, the general characteristic features of viruses, living and non-living features. These are covered in the last classes. In previous classes, we studied regarding the detailed structure and the composition of the structure of viruses. Under that, we studied nucleic acid, capsid, and envelope. We studied size of the viruses. In last class, just I will go for a quick recall. We studied regarding how the structure of the viruses are identified. These structures are identified and studied with the help of X-ray diffraction, immunology, SEM, TEM, biochemical analysis, and electron microscopy. By utilizing these techniques, we studied the structure of the viruses, where they are identified regarding their structure, outer structure, the morphology, the composition, that is the biochemical composition of the viruses, through this advanced technique. Next, in size, we studied these size are determined with the help of filtration technique. With the help of filtration technique, the size of the viruses are studied. We seen that the smallest virus is the enterovirus, which is less than 30 nanometer in diameter, whereas the largest is orthopox virus, which is 240 nanometer into 300 nanometer, that is in length and breadth, that is approximate 1/10 size of the red blood cell. Generally, these viruses varies from 10 to 300 nanometer, or it may some species it varies from 3 to 400, that is 10 to 400 nanometer. Generally, we say the 10 to 300 nanometer, in some case 10 to 400 nanometer, it may vary, that is based on the species. Next, in structure, we seen that is the nucleic acid, capsid, that and the envelope. Under the nucleic acid, we studied that the viruses contains a nucleic acid code of genetic material, which may be either of the DNA or RNA. Here, the genetic material may be of the DNA or RNA. The viruses which contain DNA are called deoxyviruses, and those who contain the RNA, they are the riboviruses. Most of the plants, they have the single stranded RNA, and the animal viruses, they may have either single or double stranded RNA or double stranded DNA. Either they may be of single stranded or double stranded. It may be of a single stranded RNA, the double stranded RNA, it may be of the single stranded DNA, or maybe of the double stranded DNA. That is depends on the species. That we have seen in the nucleic acid. In the capsid, that we also called as the protein coat. Capsid, that is nothing but the protein coat. Here, the nucleic acid core is enclosed by a protein, protective protein sheet called the capsid. The nucleic acid core, that is enclosed by a protective protein sheet called the capsid. These capsid consist of several identical protein subunits, that is known as capsomers. These capsid consist of several identical protein subunits. They are usually called as the capsomers, that we studied in last class. Next, we studied regarding the envelope. This is the protective layer. Envelope, that is nothing but the capsid. That is the protective layer, which is made up of the glycoprotein coat. It consists of two lipid layers, which gives the protection for the virus cell. This is regarding which we studied up to our previous classes. Today, we are going to see the viral structures, the different viral structures. Here, there are many different classification systems of viruses. Viruses can be classified based on the structure of the capsid, the genetic material present, biological and physicochemical properties. However, most commonly they are classified structurally or the morphologically. In previous classes, we have seen that they may be of the plant viruses, the animal viruses, either it may affect the host cell, that of the plant cell or the animal cell or the both, that we seen in the classification. Here, they can be classified again based on their structure or its the morphology. Here, again we can see the type of structure viruses. They may be of the helical, that is the helical structure, icosahedral, it may be of the icosahedral, the prolate, the or the presence of head or tail. Next, the complex or asymmetrical form. These are the structure of viruses we study in this class. The first one, that is the helical structure. Viruses with the helical structure are composed of capsomers that are identical to each other and are typically arranged around a central axis which gives it a helical form. These are the helical structures are composed of capsomers that are identical to each other. They are typically arranged around a central axis which gives it a helical form. The central portion of this structure can be a hollow cavity. The center portion of this structure can be a hollow cavity. They are also called rod shaped or filamentous viruses. Due to the presence of hollow cavity, these are also called rod shaped or filamentous viruses when they appear thin or thread like. The length and width of helical capsid depend on the length of the genetic material enclosed within, on the number of capsomers unit that form the capsid respectively. The length ranges from 300 to 500 nanometer. The length ranges from 300 to 500 nanometer and the width ranges from 15 to 19 nanometer. A classic example of a helical virus is TMV, that is the tobacco mosaic viruses, which is an RNA virus that infects plant. Here the heredity material is the RNA in tobacco mosaic virus. And the example for animal helical virus is the viruses that belongs to the family of Orthomyxidoviridae. This is the example for the animal viruses which have the helical structure and that causes the influenza disease. The most helical viruses are single-stranded RNA viruses. Here, these the most of helical viruses are single-stranded RNA viruses. See, this is the structure of helical form. As we know the structure of TMV, that is tobacco mosaic viruses. Here these are the capsomers are arranged which are symmetrical in shape and size. Here this is the hollow cavity. The center portion, this is the hollow cavity present where these capsomers are spirally arranged in the this form. Hence, this form the hollow cavity. This is in the case of helical form. They show this thin like structure. The second is the icosahedral, the icosahedral form. Here, an icosahedral shape is formed by the fusion of many equilateral triangles spherically. These are the fusion of many equilateral triangles spherically. The classic example of icosahedral viruses include polioviruses, adenoviruses and rhinoviruses. Polioviruses, adenoviruses and rhinoviruses. These are the examples for the icosahedral form. Geometrically, an icosahedral shape has 12 corners or vertices. These may have the 12 corners or the 12 vertices. 20 sides or equilateral triangles. Either it may have the 20 sides or equilateral triangles and 30 edges. It has 30 edges. There can be of two types of icosahedral capsid, that is the hexagonal or the pentagonal. Here these may be of the two types, that is the hexagonal. The capsid structure may be of the hexagonal at the vertices or the pentagonal at the vertices. That is the hexa 6, penta 5. 6 vertices, here it has the 5 vertices. That is based on that the presence of vertices, that is the hexagonal vertices or the pentagonal vertices. That is the case in icosahedral form. Next, prolate. This is the special type of the viruses in the structure. Here, viruses with prolate morphology have an elongated icosahedral shape. This morphology mostly belongs to the bacteriophages. That is the prolate form that is mostly belong to the bacteriophages, which are viral particle that attack the bacteria. These are viral particle that attack the bacteria. This is similar to the icosahedral. The prolate morphology that have elongated icosahedral shape. This is elongated icosahedral shape. That is prolate. Next, that is the head or tail. Viruses with head or tail morphology are a hybrid between icosahedral and the filamentous. These the head or tail. These are the hybrid between the icosahedral and the filamentous morphological types. That is the between the icosa and the helical form. These are the intermediate of the icosa and the helical form of the viruses structure. These basically consist of an icosahedral capsid attached to the filamentous tail. This is basically of an icosahedral capsid attached to a filamentous tail. Some bacteriophages possesses tail or head morphology of their capsid. Some of the viruses which possesses the head or tail morphology during the bacteriophages process. Next comes the complex or asymmetrical form. The complex morphology type consists of viruses whose capsid is neither helical nor isohedral. Here, in case of the head or tail, it is the intermediate of the icosahedral and the helical form. But in the complex or asymmetrical form, these capsid that is neither a helical nor a isohedral and may be of the asymmetric form. There may be added structures on the outer walls or the extra proteins that contribute these morphological classes. Due to the extra protein that present on the outer wall, hence they become the asymmetrical form due to the addition of the extra protein on the outer wall. Here, the pox viruses is an example of a complex viruses due to its unique capsid and outer layer. The example is the pox virus. The pox virus is the example for the complex or the asymmetrical form. Next, what are the functions of the structure of viruses? We studied the structure and what its function. Why we need to study the function? Because to know its behavior, know its characteristic form. Here, we will study the function of the viruses structure. First, the capsid protects the nucleic acid or the genetic content from damage such as UV light or nucleases. Here, why the presence of capsid is important? Why it is necessary to have a capsid? Because it protects the nucleic acid or the genetic material, that is the DNA or RNA of the viruses, that protects from the damage of such UV lights or the nucleases. As we know, the UV light may damage the genetic material. Hence, due to the presence of the capsid, it protects the genetic material or the nucleic acid from the UV lights or the any protein enzymes that such as the nucleases. The envelope of the viruses aids in the infection processes by initiating the attachment process. Here, the envelope present of the virus that helps in the infection process by the initiating the attachment process. The proteins present on the viral capsid as well as envelope help in the delivery of the viral DNA into the host cell. Here, due to the proteins present on the viral capsid, because it helps to make a hole on the host cell. Assume it is the host cell, the protein present on the viruses that helps to enter the viruses with the help of protein reaction, that is an enzymatic reaction which helps the viruses to take the entry in the host cell. The different structures and orientations of the capsid provide the viruses with rigidity, symmetry and shape. Here, the different structure and orientation of capsid, due to the presence of the capsid, it has the different shapes, rigidity and symmetry. Example, as we said, that is the helical form, icosahedral form. There are many forms that is only due to the presence of the capsid. The capsid helps in the packaging of the genetic material of the viruses. Here, the capsid that helps the packaging of the genetic material of the viruses. These are the few functions of the structure of viruses. Next, the importance of virus structure. Why the virus structure is important? The structure of virus is of a paramount importance to its life cycle and the maintenance of the genetic material. It is very necessary to study the structure of the viruses because to know the its life cycle and the maintenance of the genetic material. How its life cycle undergo and the maintenance of the genetic material. Hence, the study of the viral structure is very important. The different morphologies and the forms of viruses are present that are infect a range of host cells across the range of species from bacteria to the humans. Here, different morphologies and the forms of viruses that present, we know those are infect which cause the infection to the plants, animals or to the human beings based on the structure. Because if we study the structure, there will come to know what is the genetic material, either it may be of the DNA or the RNA, what kind of enzyme and the proteins are present in such cases. Hence, this is very important to study the structure of the viruses. This is regarding the different forms of structure, the function of structure and the importance of the structure in viruses. In next class, we are going to study the bacteriophage, that is the T4, bacteriophage, the life cycle, that is the reproduction in viruses. In next class, we are going to study the T4 bacteriophage, its structure and the life cycle, that is the reproduction in viruses. Today, we studied regarding the different types of structures in viruses. In next class, I will come up with the reproduction in viruses, that is the T4 bacteriophage. Thank you.